being able to use ready-made transition is really handy. You drag, drop, customize a little, and you're good to go. Like the customizable transition that we offered you in the previous video. But sometime, you will need a specially tailored transition for a particular job, and building your fusion skills will let you do amazing things. In this video, we will show you how to create your own swipe transition using Anim Curves instead of keyframes. Let's get started. As usual, we really want to thank everyone that have been joining the channel. You guys are amazing. And if you haven't subscribed already, think about doing so. The transition that we're going to build together is a slightly simplified version of our dope swipe. And while not as feature rich, it will offer you a really robust base to build your own design and extend its features. More important, what you will learn in this video will give you so many tools and will make you much more confident about creating effects in Fusion. We will also make this transition available as a polished and easy to edit template for our Buy Me a Coffee members to thank you for your support. Now, let's jump into DaVinci Resolve. Let's right click in the media pool, create a new Fusion composition that I'm going to name Swipe and Slide, create, double click to jump into Fusion. So we have one media out. As usual, I'm using a vertical layout, and if you want to do the same, go to Workspace, Layer Presets, Fusion Presets, and you can use the left or mid flow. Let's start by adding two background nodes, one for the background, one for the foreground. Those are just placeholders and won't be saved in our final template, but they will make working on this transition much easier. We'll also add two merge nodes, one for the input and one for the output. Click twice on the background icon and once on the merge one. This will add a total of four nodes, automatically connecting them and building the base for us to build on. I'm gonna arrange them and connect to the media output. Let's clean up the space. I'm going to change the color for each background for something contrasting. That's gonna be the background and that's gonna be our foreground. We are also going to rename each node to have a clear view on what they are for. So type F2. Rename, this one is background, simple. And the second one, F2, foreground. This will be our merge input. So I'm gonna name it input. And this merge will be our output. This will make the step of exporting as a template much easier later on. Next, we will start building the banner that will slide over our eclipse, and for this, we're going to use the rectangle tool. Click into an empty space to make sure that nothing is selected, and click on the rectangle icon. Let's give it a width of 1, slightly raise the height, and set the angle to 60 degrees. To give it some substance, we'll need to connect it to a background. Click and drag the background icon to the nose window, connect the rectangle to it, and drag the background node to the viewer, so you can see it. Change the background color for anything that you like, but for in this case, I'm gonna keep it white. For better control and flexibility, we won't be animating directly the banner, but rather use a transform tool to do the job. Make sure that the background is selected, click on the transform icon, add another merge node, and connect the merge to the output foreground. You can drag the output merge node to the viewer so you can see everything. Something very important that I want to mention, in Fusion, you can use the Dissolve tool to help you create some awesome effects, including swipe transitions. Why we're not using it here is because we want to create something a bit more intricate and I want absolute control on it. And the skills that you're going to develop will help you to do so many things in Fusion. I'm going to keep my nodes clean and rename them. This is going to be the banner. This is going to be the banner background. And this one will be the banner transform. And the merge, we don't care. If you want your transitions to work with any kind of frame rate, do not use keyframes for your animations. We will instead use anim curves so we can make them scale properly. To animate the banner, I'm going to select the transform node, and what you would do usually to create an anim curve is right click on a control, choose modify with, anim curves, super simple. But look what's happening if I try to animate the center control to make the banner pan on the x-axis. I'm going to right click, choose modify with, and there's no anim curve option. This will happen with any kind of control that's returning more than one value, like here where we have values for the x and the y-axis. This is because the anim curve can only take one value as an input, and we somehow need to find a way to split them up. It's actually quite simple if you know how to create custom control and expressions. To create a custom control, right click on the transform tool and choose edit controls. Few words of caution. To this date, the only way to remove a custom control is either to delete the node completely or to edit it in a text editor. So you might want to take your time and make sure you follow step by step. Create a new control, name X transform, select number for type, page controls, for the input control, screw control, and press OK. If you made any mistake, like picking the wrong control input or page, you can easily correct this by right-clicking, going back to edit controls. In the list, scroll down to find your custom control, select it, change whatever you need, and press OK. Right-click on center, choose expression, and for the X value, select it, and type X transform. This will link the X axis to our newly created control. Now we can right-click on X transform, choose modify with, and select anim curves. We have no access to a modifiers tab, full of controls and presets where we can adjust every aspect of the anim curve. Remember that the banner is supposed to slide both ways, so rather than using one of those presets or the mirror option, we'll go full control and create our own custom anim curve. For the curve, select custom, and the graph we have here represents the animation. In our case, we'll go from left to right. Scaling is going to define the range of motion of whatever you're animating. With offset and scale, we can adjust from where and up to where the banner will slide. Timing, while it's the timing of your animation. With time scale, you can choose how fast the animation will go, and the time offset will let you induce a delay. And because we want the transition to go from left to right and then right to left, we'll grab the point up there and bring it down. We now create and place two new points to define the different step of our animation. We have the banner moving left to right, waiting, and then going back right to left. To add some easing to the animation, select a point and grab the handle to add some curve. Here, a bit on the bottom, slightly. Okay, we will adjust that later. I'm going to zoom out to clearly see the whole scene, and in offset, I drag slightly to the left, just enough for the banner to exit the view. Place the clip to the moment where the banner is stopping, and here in scale, drag to the right, and place it wherever you want. I'm going to select the banner, and move it slightly on the Y, because I would like the corner to be visible. I'll go back to the transform node, and adjust the scale. Let's see how it's playing. Very good. Make sure that nothing is sticking out. Next, we add the text. I'm going to select my node and rearrange them to make some space. Drag the text icon into the node windows. Click on the transform icon. Rearrange them. And connect it to the merge foreground. As we did for the banner, we will use the transform node to animate the text. Let's rename our text. And the transform node. With the transform node selected, in the inspector, right-click on angle, choose expression, and as a value, type banner.angle. You can see that the transform is now matching the banner angle, so if you decide to modify the angle for the banner, the text will follow. We are going to create the exact same custom control as for the banner transform node. Right-click on the transform node, select edit controls, rename it xtransform, point, controls, screw control, press OK. Right click on center, select expression, highlight the X value, and type X transform. And now we're going to connect this controller to the anim curve that we created previously for the banner transform. Right click on X transform, select connect to, anim curves on banner TR, select the value. As you can see, the text transform tool is now matching the one for the banner, and it's not exactly what we want. It won't be an issue because we will be modifying this in the text node. Type your text, move it so you can see it, and format to your liking. We can now easily add a lower text or even a logo and everything we animate automatically because everything is passing through the same transform node. We're going to duplicate this text, select Ctrl-C, Control V. I'm gonna clean up a little bit and rename this to top text and the second one to lower text. I'm going to move it, change its color. Let's check our animation. And as you can see, everything connected is now animating automatically. Maybe the most important part of this transition is to create a mask that will actually do the transition between both clips. And for this, we're going to use the rectangle tool. Let's make some space. I'm gonna drag this. Click and drag the rectangle icon and connect it to the input mask. I'm going to rename it as mask and resize it. 1.6 and 3.2. Okay, we're gonna make it quite large. If you zoom out, you can see clearly. And we're going to create an expression on the angle to connect it to the banner. So right click on angle, expression, and add value. As before, we're typing banner.angle. Do you remember the two custom controls that we created before? Guess what? We're going to create a third one, the exact same. Right click on the mask, select edit controls. As a name, as before, X transform, type number, page controls, screw controls and input control, and we press OK. Right click on center, create a new expression, select the X value, type X transform, enter. As before, the X axis is now connected to the new control. Right click on the new control, modify width, and this time we're going to create its own anim curves. Go to the modifiers. For curve, custom curve. Because the mask will only go from the left to the right, we just need the curve to go upward from this point to this one. And we add only one point to match the animation curve. This is going to take some time to make it match the banner anim curve, and to make it easier, I'm gonna pin this one, go to the banner transform, and pin it as well. And this way we can see both the anim curves and easily adjust them together. Let's set the playhead to the beginning. We can clearly see that the mask needs to be offset to the left and that it's actually too low. I'm going back to my tools and here we're going to change the width to make sure that it's covering the whole area. Going back to modifiers and I'm going to change my offset. If you are using the speed editor or any other equipped with a jog dial, it's going to be really fast going through and matching your clip. Otherwise, I recommend using the trusted J, K, and L cable keys to go through your clip. J to go backward, K to stop, L to go forward. We're gonna go slowly through the clip and make sure that the mask is going at the right place. So I can see here when the banner is stopping that the mask doesn't go further. So we're gonna need to raise the scale, make sure that it's covering the whole area. I'm gonna bring the offset a bit lower as well. Let's see. Okay, now we need to adjust the curve. So every time you see that the mask is sticking out, you adjust your curve accordingly. So at the beginning, we're gonna need to add some ease to make it go slower. Okay. We're gonna go slowly through the clip. Now we need it to go a bit faster. Okay. Not bad, not bad. It's getting a bit too close. So we're going to drag this point to the right. Okay, a bit more, and a bit more. We're going to play the clip a few times to make sure that the banner is properly covering the mask. Okay, this way is good. Perfect. Now that this is done, I can unpin those tools from the inspector. Next step is optional, but it is one that will make the transition look really good. We are going to add a drop shadow to the banner to make it look like it is floating above our clips. Select this merge node, type Ctrl space or Shift space depending if you're on PC or Mac, type drop, enter, and here you just need to adjust the shadow parameters to your liking. I'm going to lower the shadow strength to 0.3, the drop angle to 90 degrees, the drop distance to 0.05, and the blur to 0.2. Now let's check how it looks on a reclip. Finally, you might want to make a template out of the design so you can use it and customize it in the edit page. If you are not familiar with how to create a macro template, we have a dedicated video that will walk you through the whole process. Before creating a template, I'm going to rearrange my nodes. Just move them around and make sure that the view is as efficient as possible. Select all your nodes except the two backgrounds and the media output. Right-click, Macro, Create Macro. Let's move the window. I am not going to go over the specifics because we have a video dedicated to how to make this macro template, but you have to select every parameters that you want to be able to customize in the edit page. Just make sure that your input node has both background and foreground selected, and your output node has output selected. Give it a name. Click File. Select Save as a group to be able to modify it in Fusion after applying the transition. In the Fusion folder, select Template rather than the macro one to be able to see it in the edit page. Select the edit folder, Transitions, and save. This way, after restarting DaVinci Resolve, you'll be able to apply the transition right from the edit page. If you enjoyed this video, leave a thumbs up and make sure to check out our playlist about VFX and DaVinci Resolve. And we'll see you in the next video. See ya!